RedShark's NAB 2025 coverage is brought to you by
Hey, this is Jason from the Premiere Pro team. We're here at NAB 2025 talking about Premiere Pro 25.2. It just came out last week, and we're here showing everyone all the new features at NAB 2025. We're going to kick it off with Generative Extend. Every video editor has been in a situation where you want to apply a transition, but you don't have enough video on either side of the cut to facilitate that transition. You replace take 4 with take 5, and now all of a sudden you have this really annoying 2-second gap in your timeline with like 500 clips on the back end, and now you have to stop what you're doing and perform open heart surgery on your timeline to close that gap. Generative Extend helps editors solve all of those problems and more. It's the first generative AI feature in Adobe Premiere Pro, and it's powered by the Adobe Firefly video model. Now, the great thing about Generative Extend, as I can show you here, we're gonna move up and do a live demo while we talk. The cool thing about Generative Extend is it allows you to use generative AI to extend your clips past what was actually captured in camera. So we can see right here, we have this clip of our heroes riding off into the sunset for the final shot of the movie. And this is one of those shots that you can't replace. It's the closing shot. This is the best take we have, but based on the timing of the rest of the timeline, we have this really pesky little gap right here, and there's no way to close it. Now, this can be a really complex problem for video editors to solve, and again, it's something we all run into all the time. But with Generative Extend, you can see here, I have my tool right here. I can't extend this clip. This is actually where the clip starts, right? So what I'm gonna do now is go over to the left. You see this new Generative Extend tool in the toolbar in Premiere Pro. We're gonna go ahead and click on that. And now what I'm gonna do is come over to where that clip began, and I'm gonna use Generative AI to just extend it. Just a beat, just for a second, just to get that extra coverage that we need. So what's happening right now is that Premiere Pro is sending this clip up to the cloud. We're analyzing every single frame of the video clip. And it's gonna take about, 1.5 to 2 minutes to generate 2 seconds of video. And by analyzing every frame, and also without needing to do any text prompting, it's going to give us an extended clip with generative AI. Now, as you can see here, it's already moving pretty fast. We're at 44%. For the sake of time here, I have another Generative Extend completion right up here on track 2. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on track 2 to make it visible here so we can go ahead and see that generation. So again, this is the clip right here, and everything within the range of this orange marker we have here on the timeline, that's our extension. So let me go ahead and scroll back right here. I'll scrub through and you can see it's really, really good. It's very, very hard to discern where the generation stops and the actual video clip begins. And if we just go ahead and play it back here, press space bar, they're riding up, and there's our generation. Now here's the coolest part about this feature. The first thing I noticed when I started kicking the tires and using it myself when this was in public beta at the end of last year, I noticed that when your camera zooms in or dollies or has an advanced crane or jib movement, the generation perfectly picks up where you left off and brings it to completion. It's really wonderful because this is a really complex, you know, jib movement. And you can see the generation started and just perfectly swoops into the actual camera movement. Another great example of Generative Extend here is a focus pull. So let's turn track 2 off again. By the way, while we were doing that little example right there, our original generation finished. So just to show you, I'll turn off track number 2. We'll go ahead and play this back. This is the one that we just generated. Gorgeous. It's awesome. This feature is so cool. So again, let's turn off track 2. Let's go to this focus pull. Again, we need to extend this clip to close a gap. And right here we can see our subject is looking at the garage. We have a focus pull back to the garage. So let's go ahead and use Generative Extend one more time. And let's zoom into the timeline. And we're just gonna go ahead and close this gap with Generative Extend. It's preparing. And again, we have another generation ready on track 2. Let's turn that on. And we can see here, let's zoom in again. So this is our generation, all of this right here. As you can see, she leans in and the focus pull is just perfect. It looks like the clip just was longer than it actually was. I'll play it back one more time. Yeah, so again, whether you're trying to close a gap, whether you're trying to cover a transition, personally, whenever I'm camera operating, I always dip the camera down like 2 seconds too soon, and I always wish I just had that little extra bit of stable handheld footage before I ruin the shot. Generative Extend will also let you go to any kind of trim point, trim the clip, and you can extend from any portion of the clip, not just the beginning or the end. So Generative Extend will extend your clips up to 4K. We also can do extensions in vertical video now, and it's available now for you to use in Adobe Premiere Pro 25.2.